Okay, next let us move for operator overloading. So under polymorphism we have seen compile time polymorphism and runtime polymorphism. So under compile time polymorphism, still it is classified into two types. One is function overloading and the second one is operator overloading, right? So now let us go for operator overloading. So in C++, different operators will have a different meaning, right? So each operator will be having its own special meaning for a data type, right? So while giving such a special meaning for the operator, we are calling them as operator overloading. Okay, so the same operator at different location, it will be acting as a different, it will have the different meaning. Right, so that is why we are calling this particular concept as operator overloading. Or the same operator will be used for multiple purpose, right? More than one different purpose it is used, so hence we are calling them as operator overloading. So what are the operators we cannot overload? Okay, so we can overload all the operators, but few operators cannot be overloaded. So what are they? So the first one is scope resolution operator, right? So where we are using the scope resolution operator? So this one we are using to define the function outside the class declaration part, right? So whenever we want to define any particular function outside the class declaration part, we will be going for this scope resolution operator, right? And the second one is class member access operator. So dot operator, right? So if I want to access any of the class member from the main program, then I need to go for dot operator, object name dot the member name, right? And the third operator is size of operator. So the size of operator also we cannot use it for any other purpose. And the last operator is conditional operator, right? And so far we didn't use this conditional operator, I hope. Okay, so this conditional operator can also be not used, or it cannot be overloaded. Okay, so it can be used only for the conditional purpose. So other than that, we cannot use this particular operator. So these four operators are more important. So which are the operators which cannot be overloaded in C++? Then you need to answer this four operators: scope resolution operator, class member access operator or dot operator, size of operator and conditional operator, right? Okay, so now let us see what is the syntax for the operator overloading. So the operator overloading, the syntax is return type operator keyword, and then OP represents the operator which we are going to overload now. Okay, so already you would have studied different operators, right? So addition, subtraction, those things you would have studied in arithmetic operations, right? You would have studied in C programming itself as well as in Python also, right? So here the syntax is return type the keyword operator, followed by that OP represents the operator. Okay, so which operator we are going to overload. And then this type of declaration is called as normal operator function declaration. Okay, so next we have another type for friend function. So we will be having friend keyword also. Okay, so I have missed. So friend keyword, return type operator OP within bracket, it will be having the argument. Okay, then how we are going to define this particular member function? So first you have to remember that since we are talking about operator overloading, this operator overloading also we are going to do just like the member function only. Okay, so it will be acting as one of the class member function only. So under that, what operation we are going to perform? So we are going to perform, if it is unary addition, then we are going to perform increment operation, right? If it is unary minus, then we are going to perform decrement operation, right? So those operations only we are going to do. So here, since we are considering it as a member function, we need to talk about the function definition, right? So it is just like the normal function definition: return type, class name, scope resolution operator, operator keyword, and then that particular operator here. And if we have argument, that argument will be passed. Then function. So this is the syntax for operator overloading. So how we are going to process the operator overloading? So a class will define the data type that is to be used in the overloading operation, and then we are going to declare this particular operator overloading function under public mode, okay, and then define the operator member function. So in the previous slide we have seen this is how we are going to declare. When we are going for declaration inside the class, declare it under the public mode, and we have to define the operator member function just like the normal member function. Okay, so using that, from the main program directly with the help of the object which is created for the particular class, we can access the operator function. Okay, so there are two types of operator overloading. So one is unary operator overloading, the second one is binary operator overloading. Okay, so we have seen that we have operator overloading concept. So under operator overloading, we are going to overload the operators. So few operators in C++ cannot be overloaded, that we have discussed, and many of the operators can be overloaded, right? So operators, we know plus, minus, those things are the operators. Then still we are classifying it into unary and binary operator overloading. Okay, based on which classification we are differentiating it as unary and binary, right? So if a particular operation consists of a single operand, then it comes under unary operator overloading. If the particular operation comprises of two operands, then it is called as binary operator overloading. So I hope you can understand the difference between operand and operator. So if I have A++, right, if I have A++, here this plus or the operator, right, A is the operand. So if I have A+B, right, if I have A+B, then this A and B are the operands and plus is the operator, right? So based on the number of operands which is involved in the particular calculation, we are going to classify it as unary and binary operator overloading, right? Is it clear? So the classification, that one you should be very clear. If you know, then no need to memorize. So, like how we have classified compile time and runtime polymorphism. So this operator overloading also comes under compile time polymorphism only. So under operator overloading, here also we are going to use the operator function. The operator function will perform the particular overloading task, right? And we are going to classify it into two types. One is unary operator overloading, the second one is binary operator overloading. So we are classifying it as unary and binary based on the number of operands involved in that particular calculation. Okay, so now let us move for unary operator overloading. So the syntax for unary operator overloading is the keyword operator and then the operator which we are going to overload, and then within bracket. So if it is a normal operator overloading function concept, then it won't have any arguments. Okay, so just remember. So if it is a normal operator overloading, unary operator overloading function, then it won't have arguments within it. But we may have another thing called unary operator overloading using friend function, right? Then it will be having one argument. So unary operator overloading with normal function will not have any argument, whereas unary operator overloading using friend function will have one argument within it, right? And then how we are going to access it? So operator, if it is plus, then plus, and then the object name, right? And then so here unary operators are unary plus and unary minus, right? So unary operators perform operations on single operand only. So it may be increment or it may be decrement. Again, it may be post increment or pre or post decrement or pre decrement, right? So these are the ways how we can show the difference. Okay, so now let us see one example program for unary operator overloading. So here I have taken a class called increment, right? So in this program, just I am going to increment the value of the variable. So I have a class increment. So I have declared two variables x and y, under public mode, I have declared getData function, display function, and the third function, this is the operator function, right? So the syntax for operator function is return type, the keyword operator, followed by that OP we have specified in the syntax, right? So that OP is nothing but the operator which we are going to use here, right? So this, with this, the class declaration part is finished. Then I'm going for the class definition part. So I'm defining all the classes outside the class declaration part. So getDataMember function I have defined, and in getDataMember function I'm assigning the value of x and y variable, and then I'm going for displayMember function. So here I'm just displaying the result, right? And the third one is the operatorMember function, right? So operatorMember function is also defined in the same manner, just like the normalMember function. Okay, so here, so what type of operatorMember function I have declared? See, it doesn't have any argument. So whenever the operatorMember function doesn't have any argument, then it comes under unary operator overloading normal operator function, right? So if it has a single argument, then using friend function. Okay, so in the same way we have for binary operator overloading also, so that one also you have to remember. So for that, first now itself let us have clarity. If it is unary operator overloading normal operator function, it will not have any argument. If it is using friend function, this will have one argument within it, right? So here x equals to plus plus x and y equals to plus plus y, right? And then we have the main program, and for increment class I have created one object I, and before invoking the operator function, if we call the member functions I dot get data, then the value of x and y will be 10 and minus 10. Then I dot display, right? So inside the display function, the x and y value will be displayed. It is 10 and minus 10. Okay, so now you just see here how I am calling the operator member function. So the operator member function will be called like this. So opx I have specified, right, in syntax. So here plus plus is the operator, plus plus, and the object is I. So by this we are invoking the operator member function. Okay, then after invoking the operator function, again if I call I dot display, then what will happen? Already the x value is 10, so again it is incremented by 1, so the value will become 11, right? Already the value of y is minus 10, right? So if I increment, then what will happen? Minus 10 plus 1 will become minus 9, right? So that will be the result for the result after we invoke the operator member function. Okay, and the important thing which we need to remember is unary operator overloading will be having only one operand, right? Only one operand will be there for making the process in the case of unary operator overloading. Okay, so here I want to give you one task. So write the C++ program for unary operator overloading, and I want you to perform decrement operation. So here I have done increment operation, right? So increment I have done. Instead of that, I want you to do for decrement operation. Okay, so then while declaring the member function itself, you need to go for operator minus minus, or operator minus you can give, right? Then while defining minus minus x, minus minus y. Okay, and while calling also, you need to go for minus I or minus minus I. So how you are declaring here, right? So based on that, you need to give this. So this is the task which I want you to do. So now let us see the example program for this unary operator overloading. So the same example which we have seen there, right? So you just see here, while declaring for unary plus, I have given only plus, Okay, but while defining the particular member function, I have defined here. Okay, so whatever I have used there, the same thing need to be used here. So when we are calling the particular member function or when we are invoking that particular function, we need to go for plus I, right? So the value of x and y is 10 and minus 10. So let me execute this. Okay, so before invoking the operator function, when if I display x and y value, it is 10 and minus 10. So after invoking the operator function, the x and y values are 11 and minus 9, right? So since I'm performing the increment operation, x value is incremented to 1, and since the y value is a negative, if I increment, it will become minus 9, right? So, what is the task I have given for you? So, I want you to perform for decrement operation. So, I am giving the operator as minus, right? Unary minus. Okay. And inside the function definition, I want to perform decrement. Similarly, here also I am changing. Okay. So, other things, no need to change. Because other things are the general member function declaration, right? So class member declaration and then function definition, we don't have any relation with other lines, right? So simply I want to change wherever it is required. So if I execute this particular program, so you just see what is the output I got. So the value of x and y are 10 and minus 10, right? So if I didn't decrement x value, it is 9. Okay, so if I decrement y value, already it is minus 10, so minus 1 will become minus 11, right? So this is the program for unary operator overloading for decrement operation or unary minus, right? So you can call it anyway. Okay, so the task which I have given you is this one. So I want you to just modify the same program, make it as unary minus, right? Unary operator overloading for minus. So I want you to perform it for decrement operation. Is it clear?